Next paper, endoscopic ultrasound guided transmural drainage of pancreatic fluid collections, a study to analyze its efficacy and complications. Author is Dr. Nilesh Konandapulle, University Surgical Unit, National Hospital, Sri Lanka.
Good afternoon, everybody. I would like to thank SLMA for giving us this opportunity to present some of the novel work which we've been doing in our unit recently. So I'll start with a short case presentation. I'm sure a lot of you all would have seen such patients, a 29-year-old male coming with acute severe pancreatitis, has a prolonged ICU stay, hospital stay, and then after some time develops some acute vomiting, which is suggestive of a gastric outlet obstruction. Here's a CET which shows this large collection, this hypoechoic mass in the middle, which is a large pancreatic fluid collection. So traditionally, in bygone years, patient would have had a surgical, what you call a cystogastrostomy, which requires, obviously it's a surgery, so it requires anesthesia, probably a laparotomy. A lot of these patients are very unwell, so not fit for these procedures. And there's a post-operative hospital stay which is associated, and there might be morbidity and mortality involved with it also. So with that background, I would start my presentation. So pancreatic fluid collections are common complications with acute and chronic pancreatitis. Some of them are symptomatic and need to be drained to relieve patient's symptoms. Traditionally, like I told, it was done surgically, but endoscopic ultrasound is a novel method where you can actually drain these collections into the stomach, which is considered safe and minimally invasive. These, of course, one of these first study done in Sri Lanka. So the method, we had 29 patients over a period of 24 months. This is done under minimal sedation, or some patient had some deep sedation. Cystogastrostomy was created with a self-expandable metal stent using a linear echo endoscope, which is endoscopic ultrasound scope. Some patients needed fluoroscopy, some did not. So to make it easy for you to understand, I've just compared on your left-hand side is the surgical cystogastrostomy, and on the right-hand side is the endoscope in the stomach, the echo endoscope, where we look at the collection from the stomach, where you see this large hypoechoic collection in the middle, on the right-hand side middle. So we basically put this metal stent from the stomach into that collection, and in the right lower corner, you'll see all the fluid coming from the cyst into the stomach. So it's basically a very natural method of draining, and it's quite minimally invasive, done over a very short time. So results, our age group of patients were 9 to 76 years, 25 of them are male, 4 were female. The reasons for doing this procedure was 15 patients had pain, obstructive jaundice because of obstruction of the bile duct was in 3 people, gastric outlet obstruction was seen in 8 patients, and the fluid collection was infected that needed to be drained, so like an abscess, was seen in 3 people. The average size of these collections were 40 to 110 millimeters, quite large. Results, all patients had successful drainage after the procedure. Generally, we only follow up these patients for 4 to 6 weeks, and we remove that stent because the full fluid collection generally settles. Some patients need a plastic stent after it for some time. The complications were bleeding was seen in one patient. The stent was displaced in one patient, but of course, all these were managed quite successfully endoscopically. One patient who had infection needed some antibiotics for about 1 or 2 weeks. So in conclusion, endoscopic ultrasound is a novel and a minimally invasive method to transmurally drain pancreatic fluid collections into the stomach with very minimal complications. Thank you.
Paper is open for discussion.
How long were these patients staying in the hospital stay? How has the hospital stay changed with your technique?
The hospital stay, so it depends. So generally you don't touch pancreatic patients until 4 weeks. So you wait for the whole collection to become a mature collection. So generally these patients would be in hospital for 4 weeks anyway. At that time only we decide whether the patient needs drainage or not. So traditionally it would have been done surgically. This is done endoscopically. So once you drain it, most patients can even go home in about 1 or 2 days. The other parameters are okay. From a pancreatic collection point of view, they can go home. Of course, if it's a chronic pancreatitis patients, these patients are not having the, all the comorbidities of other conditions, other the multi-organ failures. So these patients, I mean, we would do an elective thing. Patient is an outpatient, comes, has the procedure, next day goes home. In acute pancreatitis, it's a different situation.
Thank you.